What is going on, guys? It's Noah here with Custom RC Mods. Welcome back to the channel. Now in today's episode, I've got another FPV video. Let's go ahead and get it on up in the air. I'm flying my Schizo Nova tonight for this airplane chase, obviously, and this is my friend Alexander's guinea pig. And we're at the same exact location, same pilots. He was the one that flew this Scout in the last air-to-air video. And I'm really excited to bring this one to you because this is a very unique airplane and a very pristine night for flying. So this plane has been around for multiple years apparently. I don't know the full backstory, but I just got the general idea. Apparently it's in pretty, you know, roughed up shape. It's been crashed a few times. It's seen its fair share of woundage, and obviously it's been in storage over those years during the winters and things like that. So it has had a pretty rough life. And the wings are pretty warped, thankfully in the negative direction, just meaning that the dihedral is not really that big of an issue, being kind of the wings being droopy, because obviously when the wings are creating lift, that's not much of an issue. That's the story on the plane there. Apparently it's still good enough to fly pretty aggressively like he is there. Alexander's an excellent pilot. He also, I attribute most of his skill just for the fact that he's willing to take risks. And, you know, I guess he's gonna serve the consequences if he gets too risky, too low. But he's a really good pilot. It's really fun to chase when he's flying. But anyway, this video altogether isn't really, obviously, very planned out or anything like that. Just my raw reaction to these clips. I've watched, you know, skimmed over this thing probably once or twice since it was recorded. But other than that, I really haven't looked at this thing at all. And I'm really excited to kind of share what's going through my head here as I'm chasing this airplane. So again, this isn't really anything too far planned out. I kind of just knew that he was flying his guinea pig. I had my quad with me, and voila, I'm going to go ahead and chase him because that's something I like to do. We're not really filming a video or anything here. So it really wasn't a lot of communication going on between me and Alexander as he was flying the plane. That's something that's crucial if you're going to do something a little bit more planned out. If you're going to do something for a client, you want to know when those hero shots, when those money shots are going to happen. If he's going to do a waterfall or any of those other aerobatic maneuvers, I want to know about it because that's something that's super important to get a very good lineup on this shot of the airplane. Whereas if I didn't know about it, he's about to do something right here, I didn't know about it, and now obviously I have to make a quick jerk reaction to go ahead and get the shot, and it just really didn't look the best. So yeah, nothing on him though. Of course, we just really didn't discuss it, we kind of went up, but I'm realizing after I'm watching this footage back and after I'm kind of realizing how the shoot went, it just, you know, obviously a little bit more communication would be a very good idea, and also for safety's sake, because I know I'm guilty of this. But when we're getting close to the ground for a landing or just flying around in general, there's a lot of things to hit. There's a lot of people around there, obviously, as you can see. And, you know, obviously, I don't want to hit any of those or crash my quad. But yeah, we're doing a little bit of battery swap on the airplane. I'm flying my Nova, so it's, you know, known for a little bit longer battery life. I think I've gotten upwards of 5 minutes and 30 seconds on a single battery, so I actually didn't swap the battery here. Might have been smart to. I kind of started running out of voltage here at the end of this video. Pretty badly, but just had to swap some things on the plane and get the center of gravity kind of tweaked, and we're back up in the air. So one other thing I kind of want to talk about as it comes to flying air to air that I learned during this flight is that you shouldn't strive to go ahead and get the single shot take. You shouldn't strive to keep the airplane in frame at all times, because the negative thing about that is that you're going to be sacrificing the smoothness of your flying based on the fact that the plane always needs to be in frame. When in reality, in most filming scenarios, you're not going to be watching a video where it's completely air to air. It's going to have a ground to air shot or just a pilot cam, kind of like flight test videos have, that you're really only using a few clips of this. So I shouldn't, for the future, I shouldn't be so worried about keeping the airplane 100% in frame when I really could be using that time where I'm not completely focused on the airplane to go ahead and line up for my next shot, to go ahead and keep things a little bit more smooth altogether. And that kind of ties into the communication part of it as well. We're just flying around here. It's just really nice colors tonight. And props to this GoPro Hero Session 4. I went ahead and did some light color grading on it, just messing around with it. But it looks really, really good. And I just picked up a few of these cameras to go ahead and slap on my quads. I could have gotten the Hero 5 session, but the Hero 4 was about half the price. And especially when you're putting on a race quad, you're expecting to crash a lot. If I lose it up in a tree, that's no biggie to me. It's about half the loss there if I just settle for the resolution of 1080 60 rather than 4K 30. Unfortunately, on the Hero 5, 4K 30 is unstabilized, so it's not really much of a use anyway. So this 1080 30, I believe, has some stabilization in it, potentially. Not totally sure, but it can be stabilized in post. This is just straight raw out of camera in terms of stabilization, though, on that end as well. So yeah, really looking nice tonight, but unfortunately it's time to go ahead and land. I've reached the end of my battery here. Just went ahead and turned it around and dropped it in the grass. So that really ends this video. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Hope my voice isn't too annoying or anything like that, but either way, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.